I think that's definitely true. Marriage
is signed away your rights.
The property relation.
Right. Yeah. So that was the primary function then of everybody in the family taking the name of the father, the husband and father.
Well, that's the historical background. I mean, if we look at the contemporary situation, I think we do see other functions. I mean, the name, a woman now taking her husband's name is signaling, as Winifred said, that this bond is important, this relationship is important. But the problem is that it goes only in one direction, right? Mm. We don't generally see, although there are few cases certainly, but for the most part we don't see men feeling like they have to make a decision about names. It's women who may feel that they have to make a decision about names.
Well, when I first got married, it was very common. I was living in Berkeley, California, for women and men, when they got married, to hyphenate their names. But what would often happen, I knew of some people that this happened to, is the husband and the wife would both use the hyphenated name socially. The woman would legally change her name to the hyphenated name, but the man never actually changed his name legally to the hyphenated name. He just used it socially. So if later there was a divorce, he had nothing to go through. He still could go back socially to using his original name without anything, but the woman was legally still a hyphenated name unless she went back and changed it again.
And alphabetically, they may have been different then, because she had her Smith Jones and he was Jones.
Right.
So they were in a different place
alphabetically.
And what did they do with children then?
Well, a lot of children, I've seen this in the schools as a school teacher too, do have the hyphenated names. And that's, I think, in some ways is nicely symbolic, but it's perfectly useless in the next generation. It's difficult sometimes in that generation if the two names are quite long. They don't fit in any blanks. They don't fit in the forms. The test scores and so on get very difficult to control with a name that's much too long. But even assuming they're both very short, that can't be carried on. If you give your children hyphenated names and then they marry, are they going to hyphenate that again? Are they going to have three names or four names? It obviously has to be dropped at some point. And then in the Latin culture, where the children do take the mother's last name in a way, that also is really a one-generation thing, because then when they marry, they drop that mother's name. So the mother at least gets represented for a while, but it is dropped. So I just felt like hyphenating isn't a long-term solution, and it could be very difficult if the names are long.
But even in that one generation in Latin cultures, at least the men are also reflecting the fact that they have a culture from their mothers, and inheritance from their mothers.
That's true.
Whereas we do so much on the women,
right?
In terms of the, when you married, you had a pretty definite idea of how you wanted to handle this.
Yes,
you were young.
I was very young. I was married at 22. But I have the advantage of being much younger than my two sisters. And my older sister had changed her name, married, and then divorced. And therefore, she was now carrying around a name that she didn't belong with anymore. And my sister Charlotte, that you mentioned, they had hyphenated their name. She had at least hyphenated her name. And he also went by the hyphenated name, but like I just mentioned, didn't actually change his name legally. So again, when she got divorced from her husband...
And this was all before you married.
This was all before I married. And she got divorced from her husband. Then she went back to using Bunch, you know, which was her maiden name. So I just saw from my two older sisters, you know, why do you even pretend to do this? And hyphenating doesn't work. The funny thing is, my husband's name was Maloney, and we thought about changing our name to Baloney or Munch, which would be a combination of the names. And then he started coming up with some new names that we could take that would be different for both of us, like Mariah, and which was a popular song at the time. And I just said, no, this is much too hard. We need to just keep our own names. It was much simpler.
And he went with that. I mean, he didn't...
He had no problem with it at all. And his parents' first reaction was, well, are you ashamed of him? And when I explained to him, no, I'm not at all ashamed of being married to him. But I explained to him why, you know, I had a master's degree by then. I had started my career. And I also related what had happened to my sisters. I just felt it represented me to keep my name. And so they were only really concerned about, well, if you have any sons, we want to make sure that those sons carry on the family name. But other than the birth of sons, they didn't care.
The sons had to be Maloney.
And that was fine, because that fit with what we'd agreed to as well. So the sons would be Maloney, was perfectly fine with them.
We're going to get to that in a minute, but I want to hear about you. You also married early.
No, I didn't marry so early. I was 29, actually, when I got married, so I was a little bit older. And actually, we know from the research that when women marry at a little bit older age, like 20s, 30s, they're more likely to make a non-traditional name choice. By 29, I felt like I had had that name for so long that I wanted to keep it. And people say, Friedenfels, why did you keep that? It's so long,
right? You want something shorter.
And my husband's name is Birchall, and he kept his name. So we have different last names. I was very fortunate. Both of our families completely accepted it. We received no flack whatsoever from either family. So it went very smoothly, and we actually had fun discussing it. It was good with my husband. He was totally fine with my keeping my name. In fact, I would say he was even a little bit excited about it. And so I lucked out. I think I might not have married someone who had said to me, you have to take my name.
Mm-hmm. Have you experienced people calling you by your husband's name?
Oh, yes. Well, as I wrote to you at one point, I have a fun thing that, well, it's a little bit fun to me, perhaps not to the person on the other end of the line, but sometimes we'll get calls from businesses or whatever, and they'll say, is Mrs. Birchall there? And I'll say, I'm sorry, no one by that name lives at this residence. And I'll hang up.
So you get out of the nuisance calls.
Exactly, yeah. I get out of the nuisance calls.
And I always found it was an advantage if somebody called and asked for Mrs. Maloney, then I knew that they were calling me through connection with him, that they knew of him, not me. And vice versa, he would get calls for Mr. Bunch, and then he would know that that wasn't somebody from work, or it wasn't somebody who picked up his name from some logical place but was calling because of his relationship to me. They obviously knew me or the kids instead of that.
But were you in the phone book way back then under your name?
Yes.
Did you have to pay for that listing?
Well, actually, I did all the paperwork for signing up for the utilities, so the listing was under my name in the phone directory, and he chose not to bother to pay for his own listing. Mm-hmm. So I was under Bunch, and he wasn't listed. But that he chose to do that because we had talked about we would pay. We would just pay for the second listing.
So people couldn't have found him.
He didn't care. I mean, he felt like he gave his phone number to anybody he was interested in finding him. Yeah. But his name Maloney was much more common. See, he would have been in a long list of names, and usually there's only one or two, if more than one bunch. So it was easier.
But if someone wanted to get in touch with him, they would have to know the name of your husband, right?
Well, they would have to know my name. Somebody wanted to get in touch with him, they would know.
And then your name and who you were married to,
right?
That's interesting. What about children? Which one of you wants to tell us how you handled that?
Well, I'll start because it's my favorite thing to talk about. I really felt like the children should be named fairly, you know, and I couldn't think of any really easy way to do that. I mean, making them all Maloneys seemed to me like that was unfair. I mean, I kept my name, but the kids didn't belong to me.
So that's only one generation.
That's then. Right. Making them all bunches wouldn't be fair to him. So we decided, even before we were married, that we did want children. Whatever children we had, if they were girls, they would carry on my line and they would be bunches. And if they were boys, they would carry on his line and be Maloneys. And that was really, like I said before, the only thing his parents cared about, as long as the sons were named Maloney to carry him on. We didn't know what we would have. We didn't have any control. There's no in vitro fertilization here.
Yeah, right.
Good. In fact, we didn't even know ahead of time. I had both my children in my 20s. There was no ultrasounds or anything. So we picked out names with a girl's name with Bunch and a boy's name with Maloney, and then whenever they came out, they were named. It turned out we had one of each. I had a son first and then a daughter. So one of our children was Maloney and one was Bunch. And people, when I'd explain it, sometimes would say, well, how did the children react to having different last names? And I would tell them, they love it. They love the fact their teachers in school don't necessarily know their brother and sister, that they don't have to be.
Them.
Right, they don't have to be compared. They don't have to live up the image of the other one, that they have different last names. And
did they ever complain about it?
No, they never complained about it at all. The only ramification happened at all much later. After 22 and a half years, I got divorced. And when I was dating and considering getting married again, my daughter said to me, well, if you take his name, my second husband, then I'll be the only one in the family left that's a bunch. And I said, don't worry about it.